So the peaks, that is the top part of the mountain, is covered with snow. Not the bottom part, but the top part of the mountains are covered with snow, and that is why it's cold there. Then we come to the fourth topic, that is your plain. Now what is a plain? Plain, it is a flat landmass that does not change much in elevation. Elevation means to rise up. So plain, when we say now, like this is your book. If you see your book, it is a plain surface, it is flat. So the meaning of plain is something which is flat, which is plain. So the plain is a flat landmass. It is a body of land, or it is an area of land which is flat in shape. So plain means simply a plain area of land which does not change with elevation. Elevation means it does not change if any height is given. Most of the population of the world lives on these plains. So this area, like the plain area, is best for living, and they are also important for agriculture, and the plain area is also good for farming or for growing crops. Agriculture means to do farming or to grow crops. So these areas, the plain areas, are very good for growing crops. We grow most of the crops on it. The northern plain of India is very fertile. The northern plain, that means the plain areas which we find in the north part of our country, it is very fertile. In Hindi, fertile means upjau, and is also called the food bowl of India, because the northern plains are very good for growing crops. It is because the soil which you find in the plain area in the north part is very fertile, and it is good for growing crops. That is why it is called as the food bowl of India. The Indo-Gangetic plains, also known as the northern plains, is large and fertile. The Indo-Gangetic plain, Indo means India, Gangetic means it is taken from the word Ganga. So the plain area or which we find in India in the Ganga region, the Ganga river which flows in the northern part of India, is also known as the northern plains because it is very big in size and very fertile also. The soil which you get in that area, that Indo-Gangetic area, it is very fertile, very good for growing crops. It encompasses most of northern and eastern India. Plant life on the plains is controlled by the climate, and the plants which grow on those areas are also controlled by the climate. Okay, so thick forests usually thrive on plains in humid climates. Plains are usually well populated because the soil and terrain are good for farming, and roads and railways are easily built between rural towns and cities. Along with growing crops, the plain area is also very good for farming, good for making roads and railways. So it is very good for these purposes. Number 5 is your hills. What is a hill? A hill is a natural elevation of the earth's surface. Number 5 is your hill. A hill is a natural. Natural means again it is nature given. Elevation again means a height. So it is a form of land which is in a, which has a not a very big height, but it has a little height which is in the earth's surface smaller than a mountain. So the size of a hill is little smaller to the size of a mountain. Mountains are very big in sizes. That is why, if you must have heard the name of Mount Everest, Mount in short for mountain. So Mount Everest is the biggest mountain in the world. And here they are saying that the hills are smaller in size than the mountains. So the mountains are very big in size, and comparatively the hills are smaller size mountains. A number of hills joined together form a range of hills. Like we also saw that a number of mountains, they also form a range of mountain. A group of mountains is known as a range of mountain or a mountain range. In the same way, a number or a group of hills which are joined or which we can see together, they are known as a hill range. They may be formed by a buildup of rock, debris or sand deposited by glaciers and wind. So how is a hill formed? Now how is a hill made? How it does it form? So it is formed by the rock debris. Now what is the meaning of debris? Debris means the remain or the leftover rock or the sand which is deposited by the glaciers and the wind. Now what is a glacier? I told you that it is a glaciers are the small areas of ice. Glacier is related to something which is cold. So glaciers are the small pieces of ice which are moving, and they also make a mountain. Slowly when the pieces of ice is moving, they collect in one place and they start building a mountain. So here it is given that the hill can also be made by the glaciers and the wind. Hills may be created by faults and erosion. The hills are usually covered with grass and trees. Now, hills are very fertile also, and they are covered with grass and trees. Most of the places in the hills are covered with grass and trees. The weather on the hills is very pleasant because it is green everywhere. So the weather on the hilly area is very pleasant, very fine weather. That is why people from the plains visit the hill stations during the summer holidays. And as we know that the hill stations or the hilly areas are very pleasant, very cool, because they have a number of plantations there, they have got a number of trees. So it is a very cool area to go. So people go and visit the hill stations during the summer holidays. Okay children, so I hope you all have understood these five topics. For homework, you will be getting chapter 1's question answers, match the column, name them. So you have to write it in your classwork copies in a good writing. You must have seen in your app, you are getting the written material. So you have to copy it in your exercise book with a very good writing, and then we start with the second chapter's written work will also be given in your app. So keep checking your app and make it updated with the written work. Okay.